Victoria's dictionary. This is my own dictionary.
No way.
Yeah.
Right.
Includes all rude words. I've customised the cover. You see, it's got... I've done this over the years, various sort of creatures. It did have a Nike tick on it, but they said you can't have brand names, so I've just changed it into a swastika.
Victoria, what's your...
Well, I'd like to point out that you can make the six-letter word remain, which I'd like to have done.
Oh, yeah! That sounds to me like 48% of the audience clapping.
Is it yellowing?
Let's take a look. Okay, Victoria, you're a highbrow kind of a person. Do you have any lowbrow guilty pleasures?
Oh, yeah, well, I mean, I'm normal. If I'm tired and I want to just veg out, I'll maybe go and see an opera that's sung in translation. Doesn't need to be.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
I don't like the term guilty pleasures. I don't approve of that. My husband consorts with prostitutes. He says guilty pleasure. I say, don't worry about it. I've got ironing to do.
Just the fact you use the term consorts with. You're better than us.
Do you think creepy women are creepier than creepy men? There's so few of you.
How do you say few? There was 23 of us outside John Richardson's house, so...
Victoria?
I don't know if this is allowed. I can do 7:45 and a half. Or 7:44. Well, 50 divided by 5 times 75.
50 divided by 5, 10 times 75, 750.
Yeah. And then 9 divided by 2.
9... So you had 9, 6 and 2 and you wanted to get 5.
Yes. Yeah.
For shame.
Can I change tactics?
No, you may not.
No, that is... Well, that's 4.5.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you're...
You take it away and you get...
45.5. There we go.
OK.
So half away, well done.
I'm going to wake up screaming in the night. It was 9, 6 and 2 and I had to get 5. And literally, little John is actually leaving the chair. He's going to sit down there in shame.
Rachel, could it be done?
Of course it can be done. It's 9, take away 6, plus 2 makes 5. Take it away, 7:45. Yeah.
Victoria?
Yes? Sorry.
It's her only job. You know what? You've got a lot of other stuff going on. It's all she has is the maths on Countdown.
Sometimes if the contestants miss something really obvious, then I'll do a harder way to make them feel better.
Yes, do that.
You could have said 9 minus 6 is 3, times 2 is 6, and then 75 plus 50 is 125, times them together for 750, and take away the 5, and you've used all the numbers.
Lee is... intelligent to the point of being a bit weird and quite a sick gambler, so yes, would be the answer.
I like a bit of gambling.
What's the biggest sort of
risk I take?
Yeah.
I once didn't jump out of the bedroom window with Victoria till David just opened the door. that was quite risky, wasn't it?
Yeah, David was desperate to get out. Have you ever seen the hands-free double electric breast pump? I bet you haven't.
What do you mean double electric?
Let me tell you. The first few weeks, you're like, oh, I wouldn't let my husband see that, because you want to keep the mystique alive by month four, like a cow on a farm. And look, it says on the box, now fully hands-free. So you can do a crossword and wave at the neighbours. A megaphone, that's just to make my answers seem more credible.
Can we get a demonstration of the...
7 letters. It is a word. The thing is, we live in a... we live in a post-truth age. And this is really the post-truth replacement for scientific evidence. Look again. It's there. I just think it's got authority. And then I've got this bone of a prehistoric man that was found in a swamp, just to remind me that none of this matters.
Okay. OK, on with the game. Lee and Victoria, your turn to choose the letters.
Please.
Oh,
no,
okay.
Please let me do it.
No,
you do it. Come on.
You do it. No, I'm only playing myself.
Come on, like a married couple. Come on, you do it.
OK, OK.
You do it. I won't do it. Shame.
Constant.
You're a professional poker player, as well as everything else, but you play poker to a very high standard. What's the most extravagant thing you've ever bought with your winnings?
The first time I won a big tournament, I paid off my mortgage and I got a new kitchen. And I proudly told people that. I said, oh, I've paid off my mortgage with this and I've got a new kitchen. And everyone else in the game said, that's why women shouldn't be allowed to play poker. So the next time I won a tournament, Jimmy, I spent it all on hookers and blow.
Which of these is taller, Victoria Corrin Mitchell or 41 Victoria Sponge Cakes? Obviously, Victoria's at a huge advantage here because she knows how big she is.
How tall are you, Victoria?
Why would I reveal that information?
Very clever. You are now part of MI5.
OK, we need to get a quick answer here because the cakes are collapsing fast. That's what someone's doing. A professional's just said that in my ear. OK, so what are you going to go for, cakes or Victoria?
Cakes.
Whatever
cakes.
You want, whatever you want.
Yeah, it's got to be.
OK, bring on the cakes, let's find out.
Oh, my God, I'm not taller than that.
Victoria, if you'd like to stand next to the sponges.
The cakes are on tippy-toe.
Oh.
Yes! I think we will need shoes off.
Oh! You say that?
Well, it's got to be a shoes-off affair, hasn't it?
Whoa!
Yes!
I think Victoria Corrin Mitchell is taller than 41 Victoria Sponges.
You get the point.
Congratulations, Victoria. Congratulations. Have you got any words you'd like to say? Anything you'd like to...
No, I always thought I was short, but then they never measured it in cakes before. Oh, that's really nice. Can I take one?
Yeah, sure. You can have 41 of them if you want.
This is brilliant. This is the best episode I've ever done.
Victoria Corrin Mitchell. Taller than 41 Victoria Sponges. Question for you. If you were on death row, what would be your final meal?
Here's my thing with that question. What would you eat on death row? What's your final meal? People ask it. It makes you think about it, because you wouldn't enjoy it, would you? Whatever it was, it would taste of ashes because you're going to be imminently dead. So it's thinking about how much you wouldn't enjoy it that really brings home the awful dread of finite consciousness. Having said all that, probably KFC.
How many did you get, John?
7.
OK. James?
6.
6?
Yep.
Sean, how many?
6.
Victoria?
I think 8.
James, let's hear your 6.
Traced.
Well, I mean, that couldn't be more perfect.
Yes, I was quite happy with that.
Yeah, as well you should be. Your 6, Sean?
Tirade.
John, your 7.
Carotid.
Oh! What? As in a sort of carotid artery sort of thing? Yeah.
Yeah, excellent.
Thank you.
Good countdown word, that one.
Victoria.
Cavorted.
Brilliant.
Oh, lovely.
Cavorted. Cavorted. OK, Victoria, what things in life really excite you?
Oh, a lot of things. If you mean in a nice way, Christmas and free pens and finding a fiver in your pocket you've forgotten about or a P.G. Woodhouse you hadn't read, or if it's a sex thing, then maybe watching two men go at it. Or erotic spanking. I'm really into that.
Good to know.
I've got a key. You can't throw away a key. It could be for something useful. You can't, but I don't know what it's for. I can't chuck it.
So stuff you can't throw away, but you want to throw away.
I would feel guilty throwing it away.
The key I'm really disturbed by, because I sort of feel like you might have a basement you don't know about.
It could be, I mean...
You know that cup wasn't...